How do you think that went so far?
What?
How do you think that went so far?
I don't know. It kind of seemed like it went up a little bit, but I think it's because the log's deeper. I should have probably propped that side up. And it'd be nice if I had my gloves on.
November day. Okay, here we go on the second cut.
I'm reluctant to use this for siding. Although I don't know if this is from bugs or from the blade. That is some nice welting in there. And it's still really solid for being on the ground that long.
Yeah.
should have taken more off of this. Wide. Maybe 12 inches wide. 14 as it sits.
Wow.
We'll get a little smaller here. Excavator. Drop that one a little bit more. I didn't go far enough the first time.
There's a lever that he could drop the blade down.
Thank you.
think about it, that side would have been fine.
Wow, that's a pretty hefty slab there.
Solid. I could actually make furniture out of this. Better weather for this. Unless it didn't snow the other day, create a muddy mess for us. That would be better. But it was pretty. The other side.
13 per square.
Good. Solid.
For these rollers here.
That's
keep it wedged on this side.
Off by maybe a 1/16 of an inch. I think I'll take that. Inches by 12 and a half.
And of course you've already cut it in half lengthwise, right? Or
oh,
not.
I've cut it in fourths.
Oh, okay.
So this is a quarter of it. That's the other quarter.
Oh, okay.
And the other half is still down the hill.
That makes sense.
So, it looks like it's tearing out quite a bit here though. I don't like that.
Is it tear out or bugs?
I don't know.
This
stuff in the middle, I mean, it could be either, I don't know. If I was going to do furniture, I bet this would clean out and then you wouldn't see it, but... Well, there's a hole right there, so that might actually be bugs. And I don't see it as much over here, but it's hard to say. It's probably bugs. It's been on the ground a long time. So the fact that we're going to use it for siding on the woodshed, probably fine.
If you go slower, will there be less tear out, or how do you prevent tear out?
It would be the roughness of the blade.
Oh, okay.
But it's actually a pretty nice cut, so it's probably bugs.
Starting to pick up a little bit. figure out how to use the...
What?
Trying to figure out how to use the...
Yeah, I don't know how to use it at all.
So you can get even...
Yeah, there we go. Definitely with like the automatic work. This is... I feel like this is going to be a pain. Now I guess 1 inch or 3/4 inch siding. That's going to be really thick. We'll do 1 inch.
See how it goes.
I didn't refill it before we started.
Do you have safety glasses or something? I've got sawdust going in my eyes.
There's something on there.
Okay. I should stop it or not. Should I stop it? So this siding will go on that wood shack, woodshed slash sugar shack over there, where Cameron is planning on trying to make some syrup this winter, spring. Spalting.
Yeah. I think these are bug tails though. Look at that spalting. I don't know enough about this to know if that's kind of look like bug trails, but hard to say. Looks nice though.
Yep.
I had a kiln dry, I bet you could do it and use it inside.
Gonna put water on it or anything?
No.
I think it'll be much of a difference. How hard is it to push it while you're sawing it? Is it?
It's not easy, but it's not hard. It seems like it wobbles back and forth a little bit, so pushing out. I think the big thing would be if I had a, not this big muddy, run it out mess.
Yeah.
And these jack stands don't help either. It's not terrible, but now this thing seems to be jerking. I don't know if you need some oil on it or something.
Maybe it needs some grease. Smells good.
Water on it?
Sure.
This has a lot more of those things in it. That's kind of the center of the log of pitch. Not as much spalting either. It's the foot and the hand.
Yeah.
I haven't seen any actual bugs, but that's got to be bug. That's what it would look like with stain.
Pretty.
That's why people like that, but or if it has bugs in it, that's kind of a problem. But see, this is solid maple right there. Before you put this in your house, you more than likely want to kill them drying. I don't see actual bugs, but...
What's this?
I mean, there's holes all over, so it's gotta be bug trails. It's been on the ground for years, so...
Yeah. Thank you. to this side and see it from this side.
Something's not right.
Work it out the kinks. Be giving Dr. Akers some business, our chiropractor, shortly. Kind of looks like cellulite. So the uncutting guy said it kind of looks like cellulite.
I don't want to hit this.
hit my blade.
Say that was a pretty successful first run of the sawmill.
Got some kinks to work out. I don't know why that thing's binding. That's really irritating. It means it's not always level if I'm not careful. But hydraulics would be nice to move those logs.
Now that might be chatter.
Sitting outside all summer too, but it had rust on it, it's gone now.
Yeah. Water comes out of here.
Stuff on green, you're supposed to put it work side to the framing. 11 and a half inches is pretty wide, so it's gonna move in couple.
Cup, yeah.
Hopefully it's not super wet.
You have one of those things that measures the how dry or
one of those looks a little thicker than the rest, but we've got 11 foot long boards. And the problem is our walls are 6. I just realized I should have cut that at 12 and a half. It's like I could cut them in half.
Whoops.
Yeah, that sucks.
Okay. We're signing off now. Thanks for watching.
Well, apparently I cut this off exactly right because that's how much distance I cleared the log before I hit the stop of the carriage. So, 16 foot 4 in this particular case with about an inch on the other side. Well, there's what we got out of that log. It's 8 1 by 10 by 16s. And then kind of screwed up on the last one apparently. I've got two of the same 1 by 10 by or 10 inches wide by 16 long, but the thickness is under an inch.
So 3/4, 7/8 of an inch, something like that. So we'll see how that works out with siding the barn. The interesting thing is, same log. This is the skinnier end, so the part higher up the tree, a lot less bug, insect, worm, grub, whatever evidence. Very little, actually. You can see there's a couple spots there. There's some here. I don't know. Looks like there might have been one in there. There's another one, but compare that to yesterday's cuts with all these holes and trails all over the place. Very different. Obviously, for using this for furniture or something, you'd have to kiln and dry it and get all those things dead before you'd bring it in your house. So, but today went pretty well. I think in total this was maybe an hour and a half, maybe two, if you count getting the logs. So now we'll move it over and try to finish getting siding on that thing. So that was what we got done last night before it got dark. So sign off for now. All right, here is the finished product. We almost ended up with a perfect amount of wood. Had a couple pieces left over, but got all four sides with the boards up for the siding. We do not have battens up yet. That's going to be next year. And it's super late, and we got to bail out of here so we can go get ready for Thanksgiving tomorrow. So, bye.